actually shooting in Tennessee with I think an all American cast. I don't know. Yeah. So they are all like being exported everywhere. Yeah.
Perhaps maybe one day Malaysians, you know, should remake the Korean movie.
I don't know. We already remade Korean film. We already did.
Oh yeah.
We already did. Yeah. I think.
The Chinese.
There's a film called Along. Along PTE Limited. Jack Neo's film. Yeah. It's a remake of a Korean film. My wife is a gangster. It's a remake. I don't know if they bought the rights. I think they did.
I think I've seen them, but
yeah,
I never watched the.
It's a remake. Yeah.
I
want to
watch
it. Yeah, so sorry, But I have no problems with remakes. I'm not a purist. Some remakes are very bad. Occasionally, the one or two remakes are better than the original. I think, yeah. So I'm not, you know.
It's just like I'm songs, not, I think, right?
I think songs are. Yeah, you're correct. Yeah. So, yeah.
Okay, so,
did I answer your question? I don't know. Yeah.
Is there any other questions
that
you'd
like
to ask? Anyone? Or even the stall counters there? Anyone?
This is Asia, nobody asked me.
Okay, right. So,
yeah.
Same one.
I once saw a Korean film which was very hard to figure out. Bay of Kut. Why did Woody Dama go to
that one?
Have you seen that one?
Yeah.
Okay. What's your take on that movie? Because apparently he took a long time to shoot. Because he barely edited. He just, what he shot, he actually put on the final cut. If I'm not mistaken.
Yeah. I think so, I'm not too sure, yeah. I saw the film, yeah. It's a very beautiful film. But you should watch it again. Thank you.
Four times?
You watch it four times?
Oh
yeah, then you can watch it again. It's like a book, right? If you don't get it, read again.
Yeah.
I don't know, if you ask my opinion about the film, I think people find it hard to watch because we are conditioned to watch a certain kind of storytelling or a certain kind of narrative. So when something disturbs you, you know, something that is not that linear, that is not dramatic. Okay, you will be very, you know, like, oh, why is it not following your usual, you know? Because when you're watching a film, you have a kind of, you have a very basic expectation about, okay, this character, when you set it up this way, he, she will behave that way, you know, something would happen, blah, blah. But this film is not like that. This film, it's only interested to show you and to describe you things which is probably of a sort of religious experience. Maybe it's a very personal sort of experience from as a director, no? So he is probably not interested in showing you stories. Like, if you get what I mean, a story would have a very definite beginning, middle, end. I mean, this doesn't mean that the film doesn't have a beginning, middle, end. What I mean is he doesn't follow that sort of logic. But that doesn't mean that he is wrong. It's just that you're not conditioned to see this sort of film. You know, I mean, what do you usually see? You usually watch TV, right? And TV is very programmatic. You know, it's programmed that way. It's designed that way. It's written that way. You know, the entire viewing experience that we are conditioned or trained from is the American experience, because since, you know, the whole way of storytelling that what we're seeing now, that what is supposed to be, is actually perfected by the Americans. You see, when movie first started, it was just to record things, and the inventor didn't even think that there's anything exciting about that. You know, they felt that this invention is a waste of time. Yeah? they don't know what to do with, so they're shooting very normal things. So basically, the very first movies were actually documentaries because they were just shooting like the Lumiere brothers were just shooting their kids having breakfast. But those became very precious document of slice of life at that time because you never saw it. And when it's recorded on film, you finally see, oh, this is how they, what they wore before, you know, this is how they, what sort of food they eat, this is the train station back then, this is how a factory looks like. It is purely documentary, very straight, not even with narration because there was no sound, not even with music. Now, but very much later, some people thought that, you know, it could be like a circus, right? You know, you can record something and then sell it. So they started doing very small sketches, like, oh, let's have a robbery, and then, you know, let's have people stage the robbery, and then we shoot it, right? A few minutes. So it becomes, and then people started finding this thing very fun to watch. Very short clips, right? And they started selling those things in circus, you know, you could pay money to see it. So, in fact, movie was, in a way, a very bastardized sort of art, because you have shooting somebody performing it and selling it, you are already taking things from theater, right? So back then, those films were actually like, you know, shooting people performing, right? And then, slowly, you got music. So you borrow, you know, you want to make the scene more exciting, let's put some exciting music, right? So you have music. And then sound came very much later. So it was everything, you know. It was photography, it was theater, it was music, it was painting, you know, they stole from everywhere and it became something very unique. Right? So, and after they had done that, they found that this sort of thing was very marketable. People could make money out of it. And that's when they started shooting stories. They started, I mean, where, so you either write your original stories or you take from literature or you take from, you know, you take from fiction books, right? So of course, you started stealing from literature also. You know, you take from classics. I mean, what are the classics that you can film? You can think of Shakespeare.
Yeah.
You know, those are universal stories, Macbeth, Hamlet, and you started stealing from Russian literature, you know, the figure film, war film, you have, and then, you know, yeah, that's how it all got started, right? So, and because of that, they found a way to, well, they learned how to tell a story better and better, how to capture the audience's attention, there are ways to do it, you know, how to use music or how to not use music or how to use editing, you know. So there are different schools of editing, you know. So editing became, you know, a way of telling stories, right? In film, that's what you see.
Color.
That's what makes everything come together. Is, you know, you edit everything together. So, and then because of that, film has become a language, right? So when it becomes a language, it has a sort of logic. I mean, I cannot stand here and mumble and you won't understand, right? There's a logic to my sentence, to my line of thought, you know. Now, film, when it has to tell a story, has a narrative logic. So we are very much conditioned in watching that sort of narrative logic, and we have seen those narrative logic evolve. I wouldn't say improve, because I think improve is a wrong word. I think art never really improves, it just evolves. You cannot say that because we have equipped with better technology, you know, we paint better, and therefore, it looks like real and better than a Van Gogh painting. It doesn't work that way, right? It's the same with film. Even when I'm watching silent films now, I think a lot of the actual tech silent films are more exciting than the films now. So I think films just evolve into many different things, you know, like a kind of, like this monster.
It's your creativity, right?
Yeah, you cannot figure
every
out.
Every director has their own.
So I think we can always keep a more open mind when we are watching films. You know, I watch all kinds of films, you know, experimental.
As a director, all kinds of films.
Not because I'm a director. I watch films when I was very, very young. I watch all kinds of films.
You always have passion.
Yeah, and I'm ready to, you know, explore different things. You know, watch new films, different sort of expressions.
Yeah.
You know, so. Bit long, but yeah.
So
anyway, yeah.
Anyway, is there anything else that you'd like to add? ask you, how did you get the story coming as your director, right?
Yeah.
When did you get it?
Oh, when you mean my stories?
Yeah,
and...
yeah, your story.
Okay. I think everywhere.
When you feel everywhere.
I think being as a person, you hear stories every day, and my previous experience has been I used to collect newspaper cuttings, and I find exciting. I will cut it out, and you know, I kept like piles of them. You know, weird news, funny news. You know, because when you open the paper, all you see is interesting stuff, right? So I keep all this stuff, and then I mean that doesn't mean that I would adapt exactly one story, but that's how I find my material. Yeah, but in general, how I start a story is not it's usually with people. Yeah, I think I want to write a story about a particular person or about, you know, characters attract me first. I must first be attracted to a particular character or a feeling, and then, you know, when you have a person or a few people, things will happen, right? So yeah, generally that's how I do it. Yeah.
It's very subjective, though.
Yeah, everything is subjective.
Right.
Yeah.
Any more? Oh yeah, another one.
You can yell.
Yeah, I think.
How do you choose the actress? I mean,